हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर श्रद्धा शेके फ्रॉम के वाघ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग नासिक। दिस इज़ अवर सेकंड लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक डिजिटल सर्किट्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द डिजिटल लॉजिक फैमिलीज। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डिजिटल लॉजिक फैमिलीज एंड इट्स क्लासिफिकेशन। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ आवर वीडियो। Objectives. Objectives of this lecture are to discuss about what are the various characteristics of the digital logic families. As we know, there are the various digital logic families like TTL, CMOS, ECL, RTL, and they have the different characteristics. So, in general, we will discuss about all these characteristics in detail, and then we will be talking about the values of these parameters for different logic families. So, one of the most important characteristics is the current and the voltage parameters, noise margin, fan in and fan out, propagation delay, power dissipation, figure of merit, that is speed power product, and operating temperature. First is the voltage parameters. There are four voltage levels: VIH, VIL, VOH and VOL. Basically, what it is, as we know, in digital circuit we will be talking only in terms of zeros and ones. That means logic low is logic zero and logic high means logic one. Let us consider minimum voltage is 0 volt and maximum voltage is 5 volt, just as an example. So, while performing the experiments also, we are giving 0, means we are connecting to the ground for the logic low, and we are connecting to the VCC, that means plus 5, for the logic high. But have you ever thought that instead of connecting 0, if I give this voltage 0.2 volt, whether it will be considered as logic low? And instead of giving 5 volt as a high, if I may give voltage as a 4 volt, so will it be considered as a logic high? The answer is that yes, because there is a particular range. See, even though we are calling as a logic low and logic high, we say that 0 and 5 volt, but there is some particular range. If the value of the voltage is in that particular range, that will be considered as a logic low and logic high. Again, there is some range which is called as unacceptable range. So, if the value of the voltage is in between that range, that is not acceptable. If you observe the first graph, that graph is for the input and the second graph is for the output. So, in the first graph, if you observe, there is a logic low, a lower band called as a logic low, and the upper band is a logic high or the logic 1, and in between there is unacceptable range, and there are some values written over there. If you observe carefully, from 0 volt, the minimum value of the logic low for the input graph is the 0 volt, and that band, logic 0 band, its higher value is 0.8 volt. And if you observe the high band, that is logic 1 band, the value is 2 volt and the maximum value is 5 volt. So, particularly, just as an example, in this diagram I have considered these values for the TTL logic families, but these values will change according to the different logic families. So, let us take an example that these are these values. So, if you observe on the right side of the input graph, it is written that VIL max. See, this is the graph for the input and the voltage. This is the graph for the input voltage. That's why V suffix I for the input. If you draw the graph for the output voltage, you will write V suffix O. Now, VIL max. What is L? L is a lower band, low value. And if you observe this value, that is 0.8, this is the maximum value of this low band. That's why in bracket I have written as max. That's why in bracket you can write it as a max. Now, if you observe VIH min, what is meaning of that? The higher band, this is the higher band. That's why VIH, VI stands for input voltage, H is for the higher, high value, and in bracket minimum. If you observe the graph carefully or the diagram carefully, this is the minimum value of the high band, that is 2 volt in the diagram. So how you can define? Definition is very simple. VIH mean, just observe the diagram and you can simply write that this is the minimum value of the input voltage, high level input voltage. VIH mean is the minimum value of the high level input voltage, which is considered as a logic high, that means 2 volt. If a value which is given less than this is not considered as a logic 1. Let us take example. If I will take example of 1 volt, whether 1 volt in the first diagram will be considered as the logic 1 or logic 0? No, because it is in unacceptable range. That's why the minimum value than this will not be the smaller value than this will not be considered as a logic 1. Similarly, VIL max, just by observing this VIL max, you can write down that this is the maximum value of the low level input voltage, which is considered as logic low. If the value is above than this, will not be considered as a low. Same concept applies for the output. So only the, instead of VI, you will write VO. Observe the graph and the values. For the TTL families, VOL is 0.4 volt. That means it is the maximum value of the low level output voltage, if which is considered as a logic low. If the value is above than this, will not be considered as a logic low. And VOH minimum is the minimum value of the high level output voltage, which is considered as a logic high. If the value is below than this, will not be considered as a high value. Next is a noise margin. You know, noise is an unwanted electrical signal. Noise is present in all the real systems. The tolerance or the noise immunity is the ability of the circuit or the device to tolerate that noise. That is called as noise margin or the noise immunity. So if you observe very carefully this graph, logic 0, input and the output. This is just the difference between the voltage values, high level voltage values of the output, high level voltage values and the low level voltage values of the input and the output. If you observe the graph, see, the clue for remembering this formula is that, you know, difference you will take maximum value minus minimum value. If you observe this graph or the diagram, in the output diagram, logic 1 and the input logic 1, which one is higher value? That is output logic 1, which is VOH minimum and higher minus lower, and smaller is the VIH minimum. So noise margin is VN and H, VNH, VN is for noise margin, H is the difference between higher values. VNL, VN is for the noise margin, L is the difference between lower values. Observe the graph diagram now. In this diagram, for the low values, which is the higher value from this? Higher value is VIL, input side, VIL max, and the lower value is output side. So that's why VIL max minus VOL max. In previous diagram, we have values of VOL, VOH for TTL logic family. So if you take the difference between higher and lower, you will get the noise margin. Observe this diagram. This is again particularly for TTL families. So these are the values on the left side of the both the diagrams. The values are given. We just have to take the difference between higher value minus lower value. So if you consider the first higher, high level noise margin, or the noise margin high, so 2.4 minus 2, that is 0.4, and for the low VNL, that is 0.8 minus 0.4, which is 0.4. So noise margin is the 0.4 for TTL. Current parameters. Similar to voltage parameters, we are again having four current parameters. IOH, it is the current flowing into an output in the logic 1 state under the specified load conditions. VOL is the current flowing into an output in the logic 0 state under the specified operating load conditions. IO, O stands for output. These are the current flowing into the output under the specified operating conditions, H for high state and L for low state. VIH is the current flowing into an input when a specified high level is applied to that input. And VIL is the current flowing into an input when a specified low level is applied to that input. You will observe the diagram. Three NOT gates, that is inverters, are connected. The input of the first inverter is grounded, that is 0. So obviously your output will be 1. That means H. If you observe the current which is shown over there is IOH, that is IO means output, high, whenever the output is high. That output of the first inverter is given to the input of the next inverter. So that will be considered as the input current for that inverter. That's why II and H, because its input is high. If the input of the second inverter is high, obviously its output is low. So in that case, its output current is low, that's why IOL, and that low current is again applied to the next inverter, that's why IIL, because for the next inverter it is acting as an input current. Similarly, fan out is the maximum number of the standard logic inputs that an output of an IC can drive reliably. Reliably means what? It is the number of the inputs that output of an IC can drive without falling outside of its current and voltage limits. Observe the diagram. In this diagram, first inverter is connected, and that inverter is connected to the input of n number of the other inverters. So in this case, the output of the first gate should be able to provide sufficient input currents to the other gates, right? That's why, that is how it is called as without falling outside of its current limits. So fan out is also called as a loading factor. Gates which are having higher fan out are slower. The formula for finding out the fan out is that it is basically the ratio of high level currents and low level currents. So observe the IOH divided by IIH and IOL divided by IIL. We have to find out maximum value among this and which is considered as a fan out. Next is a fan in. Fan in is very simple. It is number of the inputs to a logic gate has. The gate with the larger fan in are bigger and slower. So this is an AND gate which is having m number of inputs. So its fan in is m. Then, regarding to the timing of the logic gates, we know what is a propagation delay. Basically, propagation delay is the time required for a signal to pass from its input to the output. For any circuit, if you give the input, we expect that output should change at the same instant of time, but it is never possible because there is a propagation delay. That propagation delay is very small, in nanosecond and microsecond sometimes, but it is there. Observe the first graph in which the waveform is changing from low value to the high value, and the output is changing from the high to low. This is the waveform of the inverter. Our expectation is that the instant when input is changing, at the same instant output should change, but it is not possible. The dotted line represents the 50% of the your timing. When your output is changing from the low to high, or 50% of the voltage level, you can say. First vertical dotted line says that it is the instant when input is changing, and if you observe, after some time instant output is changing. Same thing is for the output. So TP is for the propagation delay, HL is from the when the output is changing from high to low, that's why TPHL, and TPLH, TP is for the propagation delay, and LH is when the output is changing from low to high, and the average of these two is called as a propagation delay, that is TPD. Power dissipation. Every IC needs a certain amount of the electrical power to operate. For TTL, we say it is a VCC. For CMOS, we say it is a VDD. Power dissipation is determined by ICC and VCC, that is current and supply voltage. So, average current is ICC high plus ICC low divided by 2. Average current, average ICC is the average value of the current in high as well as low level, and the power dissipation average value is ICC average into VCC. Speed power product. This is one of the important characteristics. This is also called as a figure of merit. See, for any logic gates, what we expect that it should consume very less power, or very less power dissipation should be there, and its speed should be very high. That means its propagation delay should be minimum. And if you take the product of these two, that is called as a speed power product. So it measures the combined effect of high speed, that is low propagation delay, and low power. So for example, one IC is having an average power dissipation of 10 nanoseconds, and average propagation delay of 10 nanosecond, and average power dissipation of 5 milliwatt. Then its speed power product is the product of these two, that is 50 picojoules. So these are the characteristics we have discussed. Thank you.